When we have a decentered IOL, the question is how do we proceed? I'm going to show you two decentered IOLs and show you how to proceed with them. As you notice here, it's a beautifully decentered IOL. One of my colleagues put it in and left me with this little thing to bother around with. How do we manage it? Let me show you this method, which I think is quite a little unique. I think you'll like it. What we essentially need to do is to put two marks at 3 and 9 o'clock and at 4 and 7 o'clock. Then you simply dissect the conjunctival loose on both sides. Having done that, we use a micrometer diamond gauge, set it at 30 microns, 35 microns, and all we then need to do is to make two little grooves running at the side. This is the tip of the diamond knife. All we now need to do is hold it and run down at the edge of the iris on the limbal zone. So basically we have made a limbal incision which is vertical, through which we will now insert a 10-0 proline suture which is double armed. This is a standard suture, W1713, that's a code number which we utilize. And all we now need to do is insert this needle in a manner in which it goes to the other side. Insertion, of course, at the first place where we have made the first incision, under the iris, supporting the cornea, and from the other side, we insert a 25 gauge needle through which we feed in the suture. The needle enters it easily when the 25 gauge needle is removed, it comes out. So far till the present moment, we really have done nothing much excepting to make two little, some minimal thickness, 35 micron thickness. Remember, the thickness of the sclera at that point is 70 millimeters. You hold the proline, take it out, and cut the two loops. So you now have two ends. Now we have to suture this IOL to stabilize it. One of the easy ways of doing is to rotate it until it comes into the anterior chamber. The anterior chamber is the safest place for IOL to be. It will not slip out, it will not move out. You remove the adhesions and take it off. There were no vitreous strands at this point here. So there was no reason for us to go and do a vitrectomy. Otherwise, at that stage, I would have done a little vitrectomy. Now, we need to get one of the edges of the loop of the lens. You don't have to pull the whole loop out. If it comes out, okay, you don't have to pull it. And to one end of the loop which has been exposed, you suture one end of the proline, which we had originally taken out and cut into two parts. Easy way of doing it is to loop it and then to put a double stitch. Once that is done, you trim it a little short and just tuck it in again. You can notice the proline on my left hand side. When you tuck it, the lens will rotate to the place where you want it to go. You still leave it in the anterior chamber. Don't put it back. Next step you do is to rotate the lens around so the other loop comes out, and then gently remove part of the loop. Here the entire loop is slipped out, but it doesn't make a difference. Remember to always tie it at the point of maximum convexity of the loop, because that is the point which you really want it to slip in. Now the next step which you do is you rotate it in and then pull both sides, because the lens has to rotate back into its place, which it will do. Now we have a perfectly positioned lens. Now comes the interesting part. Bury your needle in the depths of the incision. Take it out and tie your suture. One end, two, a double at one side, one at one side. Sutra gets buried into the groove which you have made. Makes it very simple. Similar manner. Take it, depth of the incision, and pull it out again at the other end of the incision. The whole idea being is that knot has to be buried. Once the knot is buried, you no longer have anything more to bother about. As you look to the lens, you know it's a PMMA lens, and you know for sure that if you try pulling it out and trying to, gum it to the surface, probably one of the loops will break. So this is the safest way of handling it. You apply your sutures, tighten it, and that's, once the sutures are tight, the suture goes into the depth of the incision. Trim it and cut it. You no longer have to bother about the conjunctiva. The conjunctiva will retract upon it by itself. If there's any edge which is left over, all you need to do is to just snuck it back into place. Nothing more needs to be done. All you now need to do is just press the lens. Till now the optics were lying anterior to the iris. Now they are lying posterior to the iris. So you have managed to recenter a decentered lens with a very simple and a very easy method. I have another little quick video just to show you. Sometimes multifocal lenses de-center, I call them snag. Now this is a multifocal lens which was done. There was a traumatic injury and the lens implanted 4 months earlier de-centered. Odd injury, a spoon hit the eye. Now if you look at this, you know it's a plate haptic lens. You can't suture a plate haptic lens. The only way you can have is removing it. But what I wanted to bring out to you is that more often than not, there is a simple way of recentering these eyes, multifocal lenses. What you need to do is to snap two ends of your haptics out. Put it into the anterior chamber and rotate it. Or put it into the front of the eye, I'm so sorry. Put it in the anterior chamber and rotate it out. So the whole secret is to flip the haptics. You will notice the way of flipping a haptic of this lens is press from the back, hold from the middle and flip it. Automatically the edge just flips out. Don't try pulling it because then you will break the capsule. Once you flip the edges of the lens out, now you know both edges of the lenses are flipped. If it rotates fully, you have desnagged it. Move it gradually along the line and then snap it back into place. Always go to the opposite pole wherever it was. If it was at 90, 180, which is what you, if it was at 90 and 0, then you flip it on the opposite side. Now you get the edge of the lens and flip it in again. And the lens will snap into place. Usually multifocal lenses snap in with no difficulty. Thank you for your attention.